Okay, so we have another 1v1 zero AD game where I will hopefully beat this player who looks slightly like a noob. Just from his initial rating. Okay. Set everything up. So I've been testing out rating, and it's actually been much more successful than I thought it would be, where if you raid with cavalry units, which I'm going to start building now, which are actually much better at farming than the, I mean, m not farming, at hunting animals than the women are, you can get a higher food supply very quickly, and this allows you to, in turn, attack faster, though it does leave you a bit lower on wood than you would be normally, so I'll be struggling with wood for a while now. So what this does is it forces the opponent to kind of adopt a mindset and play more defensively. And by playing more defensively, they hand a lot of the field over to me. Oh, jeez, no, there's farm over. They hand over kind of the most of the map to me because they can't effectively collect resources, among other things. And because if you can't collect resources effectively in this game, you won't win. That's pretty much a given. Okay. Yeah, this is the whole, oh geez, resource drain in the beginning, and dang it. Okay, so it looks like we're playing against Persians, who have the benefit of fortifications. How well they will perform once they're out of those fortifications, though, is another story. And hopefully, if I play my cards right, I can use my advantage of cavalry as well as other units to completely. Disrupt or kill any attempt by the opponents to build up a sustainable ecosystem. I mean, my bad, industry and stuff. Ugh, darn it. So right now, because it's a Persian player, raiding is a lot more difficult as most of his stuff is walled and walls are just really annoying to deal with in this game because you need rams and stuff, or basically a huge amount of units to actually get through them, and you won't have that this early in the game. As a result, I'm really left with the only other option, which is to kind of wait until he gets to level 2. And once he has to go and farm outside of his base, then I can start cavalrying him more effectively because the resources you see in this initial base area here, these run out pretty quickly. Much faster than you think, unfortunately, for the opponent. And he will very soon have to deal with a complete lack of space for farm, among other things, and be forced to leave the comfort of his base where my cavalry can slowly rip him to shreds. Now, what's special about this map is not only are there lots of kind of supplies of food in terms of animals just hiding out around the base, I mean, around the map. But it's that they have these elevated up areas up here, which are actually really easy to defend. So this makes it more difficult for my raiding tactics, but not too difficult because players are normally pretty careless with their units, and if their reaction time isn't high enough, I'm really going to catch units out of position and then kill them. So at this point, I'm just trying to get a little surplus of food and then set people to building wood and I need another farm. Okay. Okay. So now I'm going to, oops, set my people to farming for a bit. And send these 8 units of cavalry out for some raiding. I'll leave one guy out as a scout and send the rest around the back of the person's base, because that is normally the... Oh, as you can see right here, we already have some areas with very little defense. And if I destroy this, then that's going to be like 500 wood. I mean, 300 wood. Already, with just that small attack, I've essentially disabled a very large part of the enemy's production here, and an even larger part will be disabled when I take out this woman. What? When I take out these women right here. Okay. Because that, at this point in the game, is like a quarter of, I would say, their population. And it's quite hard to come back from losses like that this early in the game. It's kind of like tactics that do really seem pretty cheap to actually do to people, but they're extremely effective, as I've seen. Though you gotta remember, the more experienced the player, the more likely they'll be prepared for your attacks, not only that, or they'll kind of react faster. Like, as you saw with this guy, he didn't really counter it in time to do anything or save any of these units. But a more skilled player would likely have... Yep, see, that one's dead. Would likely send out reinforcements to help their dying units, or just react in a way that wouldn't get everyone killed. So when you see kind of just initial success like that with an attack tactic, it's pretty much better to just double down on it and do it even more. So now I'm going to build even more cavalry and just keep sending it in to attack him, since my opponent has shown a very large lack of knowledge in how to deal with such raiding tactics. It's basically like, I'm under the assumption that he's kind of safe in his base, but anytime he leaves, even for a second, his units are going to get killed. And this will have the slow effect of eventually draining his manpower, because all his units will be dead. It'll drain his resources, because he can't collect anything because his units keep getting killed. And slowly but surely, he will run out of stuff, and then he will die. As you can see here, he doesn't really even have enough defenses for me to not just go out and just attack everyone in his base as... Oh, okay, I guess he does. Okay, so he is actually competent enough to put his people inside of buildings. So once they're... yeah. Basically, I raided him so hard he quit the game. See, that's... What I've seen is the kind of counter to building women early. Yeah, he was pretty annoyed at my tactics, but frankly, if you can't defend your units here and let them die that easily, then I'm not really sure why he's saying it's lame. He lost because he was less skilled, not because of any actual flaw in the game or anything. He was really playing as the Persians, so he could have just used his wood sources around here until he was able to build a large enough army to defend here. Because if, let's say, instead of the units he had there, he had maybe at least 5 spearmen in this kind of massive units he had defending here, then I wouldn't have been able to touch him. Because spearmen not only do 3 times the damage to my cavalry, but they also have more armor and they die slower. So basically, if he prepared even like the slightest defensive units to counter me, then my cavalry would have been half as effective, and he wouldn't have slowly lost not only his barracks, which was the essential loss, because that's 300 wood and puts him massively behind and makes it so he can't build units as fast as I can, even though I had no barracks. But he basically lost a huge kind of investment in terms of money and resources that early in the game, while I was still pumping out units just as quickly, and it meant that he had no way of recovering and slowly was put onto the path of defeat and eventual destruction. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.